I always try to remember the depth, especially if you're looking at doing an injection or something to that. Make sure that you have a long enough needle to get to the target that you're shooting for. So we talk about transducer movement when we're talking about how to best get the picture. And when I'm coaching people what hand motion to use to get that picture to really be sharp and clear. So we have that heel toe maneuver, as well as the toggle maneuver. Sometimes you call it the wig wag maneuver if you're the dog wagging the tail. And then I really always think about this ultrasound probe as like a flashlight. So this is a transducer beam orientation. Don't forget, if you want more about the business of Orthobiologics, I have a podcast, or you can go on my website, the business of Orthobiologics, and tune in. So basically, the linear probe is pushing sound waves out, and you can see in a clear path directly beneath the transducer, just like a flashlight. And just like a flashlight, you shine, quote, shine the waves or the beam to the location that you're trying to see underneath the transducer beam. Additionally, on the side of the screen, you're going to be able to see markings showing depth of measurement, and you can adjust the depth with the buttons. But this is a picture of a posterior aspect of a shoulder, and you can see that the transducer, this is a linear transducer, and the beam is showing directly posterior. And you see the glenohumeral joint with the H being humerus, G being glenoid, and the rotator cuff overlying that as well. With skin being at the top of the square right here, and then the lusoriliar tissue, deltoid, tendon, muscle of the rotator cuff tendon, humerus, glenoid, and labrum. And so ultimately, I always try to remember the depth, especially if you're looking at doing an injection or something to that, make sure that you have a long enough needle to get to the target that you're shooting for. So these are our ultrasound textbook references. Please, if you're wanting more guidelines, the AIUM guidelines is a great guideline, and the ESSR is also a great guideline to be able to go ahead and look online, and they can kind of run through all of that ultrasound examination. And then don't forget, if you want more about the business of Orthobiologics, I have a podcast, or you can go on my website, the business of Orthobiologics, and tune in. Otherwise, thanks so much. I will see you next time.